If you watch the Ophaur pet video, you would know that it is possible to keep an Ophaur as a pet, although they can be hard to handle. So what if, in another timeline, Ophaurs were domesticated? The clotting effect that their venom has can be lethal without treatment, but a domestic Ophaur can have multiple important uses. They can hunt vermin such as rodents, be great companions, and their natural protectiveness allows them to be excellent livestock defenders. Ophaurs are already somewhat social, so domestication won't be too large of a stretch. This hypothetical Ophaur subspecies will be known as Neoboria toxicodon domesticus. Perhaps it is descended from African Ophaurs, Eurasian Ophaurs, or a mix of the two. Once the Ophaur becomes truly domesticated, they'll go through all sorts of physical and psychological changes such as a smaller head with smaller teeth, less potent venom, and a more friendly demeanor. Neotenic traits such as pink noses and yellow eyes will also become more common. Eventually, people will begin to select for specific traits in Ophaurs, some practical, some aesthetic. Companion breeds will have absent or reduced venom glands, an easily manageable size, and a calm and agreeable temperament. Hunting Ophaurs will be bred for their obedience, reaction time, agility, and sometimes venom. Guard Ophaurs will be bred for size, strength, courage, and protectiveness. All domestic Ophaurs would have extreme variation in their fur. Tabbies, calicos, tuxedos, piebalds, the possibilities are endless. Their fur can be short, medium, long, or in some cases, have no fur at all. There's a dark side to the high degree of variation though. Some people are so concerned with the looks of an Ophaur that they will breed them to look better regardless of the side effects. As stated in the previous video, Ophaurs with blue eyes are more often than not, deaf. People would breed Ophaurs with this recessive gene anyways because their eyes were so beautiful. However, they had to deal with the issue of 80% of blue-eyed Ophaurs being deaf. Assuming that the Ophaurs involved laid an average of a dozen eggs, only 2 to 3 hatchlings would be able to hear. As seen in many cases of selective breeding, inbreeding was unfortunately involved. Eventually, it would get to the point where the odds of a blue-eyed Ophaur being deaf were much slimmer. This still doesn't make up for the amount of damage done. There was an attempt to create teacup Ophaurs at one point, but it just didn't work. Why? Because the Ophaur shrunk before their eggs could. This guaranteed all their eggs getting stuck inside of them, leading to their death. No Ophaur breed has females that grow below 50 pounds. Fortunately, huge Ophaur breeds could easily happen. I've already talked about how Ophaurs get to 120 pounds, so people could breed Ophaurs to be that size consistently. And that's a glimpse at what domestic Ophaurs could look like. Please note that nothing in this video is canon, and any topics here will likely never get covered again. Would you get a domestic Ophaur as a pet? If so, subscribe.